In 1972, a crack commando unit was sent to prison by a military court for a crime they didn't commit. These men promptly escaped from a maximum security stockade to the Los Angeles underground. Today, still wanted by the government, they survive as soldiers of fortune. If you have a problem, if no one else can help, and if you can find them, maybe you can hire the A-Team.
One hot summer day in the early 1820s in South Carolina, a skilled wood carpenter named Denmark Veazey was working on a fence around a wealthy slave owner's house. While he was working, an angry white abolitionist came up to the house and knocked on the door. He said the following.
I, Eli Gorbinski, hate all slave owners and even go as far to say I hate slavery in general. And that's why I, Eli Gorbinski, shot and killed this here slave owner. Oh my God!
Denmark Veazey paid no attention to these actions and tried to continue his work. Within minutes, law enforcement arrived and saw the dead slave owner and a black man nearby and concluded that he had to be responsible for the murder of George Pinkley, the slave owner.
There were a few witnesses to the crime and they testified. In fact, one person had even drawn out the crime scene as it happened, for she was an artist and had a tablet and pencil in hand. Later that day, detectives visited the crime scene and searched for evidence. They found a gun with Eli Gorbinski's name carved in it. The gun also had buttery fingerprints from the ear of corn he had been eating during the shooting. Also at the crime scene, the detective found a confession letter signed by Eli Gorbinski. When the detective questioned the witnesses, they informed the detective that Pinkley's final words were, "Eli Gorbinski shot and killed me." After only about 20 minutes of trial, Veazey was convicted and hung on July 2, 1822.
Tell us a story, Grandpa.
Grandpa, tell us a story.
Okay. I remember back in the 1820s when slaves were told that we were no longer on the task system but on the gang system. When we were on the task system, we were able to have some free time once we finished our work. We could do anything that did not include gathering in large groups, to learning how to read, basically anything that the master thought was not right for slaves to do. Some slaves were even given permission to have a job away from the plantation, but they were paid very little money. When the gang system was enforced, we had to work from sun up to sundown, with hardly any breaks. We did, however, form two major groups, the field boys and the house boys. I myself was a field boy.
The field boys were quietly talking among themselves as they worked. The houseboys walk outside to get some more water and some meat from the smokehouse for dinner. They looked around to make sure the master was not close and then walked over to the field boys to start an argument.
Houseboys, look at them over there picking cotton all day. We're better than them, cause we stay in the house all day.
What'd you say, houseboy? Only after you lazy, cause we stay out here in the hot sun and work all day. You want something, go get something then.
What is this? Get back to work! This is the gang system, not the task system. We work sun up to sun down. You, slave, punishment. Slave, punishment, punishment.
What? I'm sorry.
Welcome to the Erie Canal. The canal will run for 363 miles from Albany, New York to Buffalo, New York when it was completed. The canal was the first transportation project that did not require portage. It was faster than carts and animals and caught cuts by 95%. Building such a massive structure was not easy. Okay, there goes another one and another one. In the end, over 1,000 workers died because of fever and mosquitoes. After many hard and trying things, the canal was finished on October 26, 1825. The canal helped the local economy and supported an increased trade. National Road, finished by 1839, provided a gateway to the west for thousands of settlers. The road stretched from Baltimore to Vandalia, Illinois, and was one of the only thoroughly funded road projects. It was a major economic benefit for the country.
The election of 1824 has been known as the corrupt bargain because of the deal that was made between John Quincy Adams and Henry Clay. This election came to show that the era of good feelings had come to an end.
Hello and welcome, America. Today we are interviewing the top four candidates for the upcoming election. We have John Q. Adams, Henry Clay, current Speaker of the House, Andrew Jackson, a war hero, and William Cowper.
How do you feel that the Constitution should be viewed?
I believe that the Constitution should be viewed exactly how it is written and no other way than that. A strict interpretation is what I believe in.
Good, I see. So Henry Clay, how do you feel about the American system?
Well, I'm 100% for the American system. I think we should develop a national bank and work on projects that improve the nation. Also, I think we should make the national road. To fund a national road, we should use tariffs.
I see. So you think we should tax the American people?
Yes, we should. A lot.
Interesting.
John Adams, do you agree with national improvements?
Yes, I believe our nation should make improvements because we're still a young nation. But I do not believe we should tax the people for those improvements.
Andrew Jackson, since the American people don't know much about your political views, tell us about them.
Anybody want to speak up?
First of all, I'm a Democratic Republican from Tennessee. I believe in a smaller federal government and a larger state government. I also believe that agriculture is the key to a healthy nation and should be expanded.
Very nice. That concludes this interview with John Q. Adams, Andrew Jackson, William Cowper, and Henry Clay, also known as
gathering in large groups,
Keep going, keep going, keep going.
Some slaves needed to leave the plantation. But they were paid little money. When the gang system was enforced, we had some work. We had to work sun up, sun down. We hardly ever worked. We did, however, form two major gangs, the Field Boys and the House Boys. I myself was the Field Boy.
I'm sorry, I called. Can you do that again?
See why?